and being a millennial is, our generation right now. Like, we are born between like 1980 and 1995, and I have an album coming out called Millennial, and it's talking about autumn topics, and I want to just talk about like the different unique stuff that kind of reflects this generation and why we're so different, why we stand out from those who came before us, those who come after us.
Places we could go with. I mean, because we're very, there's this social networking piece that's very much a part of us. And then there's also, I mean, in some ways, I don't know, I would say, but I don't know, that could be any teenager. I was going to say this history, in some ways, sometimes there's a disconnect between historical piece too. So. I've read something that they said we're the Facebook generation. But you know what? I think, and not to be complicated, but if you put race into it, I don't know how different it is among cultures, different races. I know as far as African Americans go, I think if you start talking about our generation, and maybe even the generation right before us, there's this disconnect between historically kind of our history and then maybe how we identify ourselves, and I think that's something that I think that's something that I know for me that I didn't know a lot about until I went to college. You know what I mean? So I don't know, between culture lines, I don't know how it differs, but I do know.
I feel like when I was brought up, I don't know if it was just because of the schools I went to or anything, but like I was always like taught about my people and who I am, like from, I don't know, just from even going to the schools that I went to, because I didn't go to regular public schools all the time. I went to like little Afro-American church school and stuff, so.
I don't know what kind of really made me like think about this topic. I work with kids, and so I was sitting with my wife's day, working one day with a 10-year-old, and she told me that her school banned electronics so she couldn't read. And I was like, what do you mean you can't read because they banned electronics? And she's like, oh, they took her Kindle away, so she couldn't read. And I was like, you don't need books, she don't own no books, everything's on her Kindle. I started thinking about like how deeply like delved into like technology that like, the new generation is.
They are.
Where like they have no idea about the other world. Like for me or for people like us, I feel like 20 somethings right now,
we're the last generation to really remember that shit back then.
We're like well versed in right now, but like we still remember when you had to get up and turn the TV with the knob.
I remember Mario teacher typing, like I remember like when there really wasn't no internet, like when Kaza was like the shit.
When you had to tell somebody to get off the phone.
But we still mess with like this new technology. But like the younger generation,
they're
all the way there. Like even working at a school, like I can say a good thing about them though, like as far as like diversity and like being like aware and like not even aware but like welcoming of different cultures, like they're better than us at. Like I work at a school, I work at Ann Sullivan, so to see Native American kids playing with white kids, dating black kids, and like a Latino kid is like all in the same group, and they're all like, and they don't even really notice it. Like race is still an online issue, of course, but they don't really notice it. Like that shit's amazing to me.
It depends on where you go with like, integration, bro. But like, at the same time, like most of the racism is amongst like our parents and stuff, and their generation. It sounds kind of bad, but like once their generation passes, then it'll be just our generation. Yeah. I feel like it'll be like a lot more diverse between.
How was that like growing up? Because
I got a lot of friends of all different backgrounds, everything. So.
Something that I've kind of always wondered is that piece too. I mean, is this piece where you know, like teenagers? This is my example, right? So how we know teenagers be, well, at least I know, and talking to people, is they're kind of in this phase where they know everything. right? Mm-hmm. And they want to, and part of me is, and even where we are right now, is because if you go back to the 56, people our age were doing this, what were they same doing? Shit. Same stuff mm-hmm. we're doing. And so part of me sometimes wonder, is it who we are as this generation, or is it actually just where we are in our age? Because sometimes when people grow, they grow into who they, who, you know, later on. And so just because, sometimes I wonder, just because we are who we are now doesn't mean that later on we're not growing into who
they are. I feel like it's a little bit of both. Like, I feel like, inevitably, like, I'm growing into my dad, like, and I can't even stop it.
Yeah,
like, I get angry, like, I'm so angry. Like, I was talking to my cousin about some shit, and I was like, I was telling him to apply for a job, which is off bat, like, my pops. But then he was like, he was just agreeing with me, he was nodding his head. I'm like, he's not even listening. You're not even gonna do it. Don't do it right now. I'm like, oh, man, that's something my dad would say. But, like, it's a little, so I feel like it's inevitable that, like, we grow into, like, who our parents were, and then who, like, 20 through 25 year olds are, like, as a age bracket, like, generally in society, because it is like some repetition. But then I feel like it's something special about us at the same time. There's something there, but I don't really know what it is. But
I think like the special part is, like, we are just, like, well versed in both sides of the world. Like, as far as tomorrow, if technology got cut off, we still know how to work.
I'll be sure.
We still gotta like function in life, as far as, like, all the simple manual stuff that we're doing. Like, we're like the new generation of kids. They'll shut down. They don't know what to do. And then I think about, like the older generation can't really function as well in the new world they're in right now. All the technology stuff, they're kind of like detached from that. So it's like we're like the last generation who has both sides of the world, both of them, from the technology side, from like the analog side.
But is that like, but aren't we teaching them to do more hands-on? So I feel like we're like,
that's
like, but I don't know who's really teaching them. Like, I'm trying to teach, but I don't know if anybody ever, like, thinking about how they're not, like, well-versed in, like, the simple things.
I'm saying, like, as a whole, just, like, in a normal school day, because, like, I remember we used to have overheads, and now it's, like, going to a classroom, it's, like, smart boards. So, like, I think about all the, like, the advances in technology, and I feel like we're welcoming them to be
crazy.
Pure,
without teaching the value of that technology.